Alright guys, today we're going to do another mod on the Yugoslavian M77. This particular modification is actually not to the rifle itself, it's to the magazine. The M77 308 comes with a 10 round magazine, and it's just like a lot of your AK magazines out there. It has a locking feature on the front where it pops into the front trunnion, and it has the mag release wedge in the back for your mag release. Well, right now that's all that's currently available. You can't get anything larger than a 10 round mag. But I found a modification in a forum online where you can take a 20 to 25 round M14 magazine and you can modify that for Yugoslavian M77. And this one has not been modified, but we're gonna go ahead and modify it so you can see how to do it. It's fairly easy, it's not very difficult to do, but this particular mag is a Checkmate Industries magazine. Checkmate Industries currently makes the magazines for the US Navy for their M14s, so that's the ones you're going to want. You'll see magazines out there that are being sold as military surplus, Taiwanese surplus, and you have to take a look at them. There are a lot of fakes out there. There's a lot of junk in the M14 magazine market, is from what I've found out. And if you can just buy a Checkmate Industries mag, do that. All right, this is a real easy mod. Let's go ahead and take a closer look at this magazine, and then we'll modify it. All right, what do you have to do to the mag? Well, the first thing we have to do to this magazine is cut a notch across the front of it. To give myself a guide, the notch is basically the width or the height of this square cutout here in our magazine. I'm going to come down a little bit lower than the square cutout, put my tape on there, put a piece of tape across the bottom so I know how far to make the cutout. Alright, now that I've got it marked with tape, I can begin making my cut. One of the things though, a precaution I want to take, is I want to depress the follower in this magazine. Depress the follower and shove a piece of paper towel or something in there to keep the dirt and the metal shavings from getting inside the magazine. Alright, now you can see the paper towel sticking out. That keeps it from having to pull the whole magazine spring out and everything. And it'll work just to keep the crap out of it. Alright, you'll probably make this modification similar to the way I'm doing it. You really can't put this in a milling machine vise or anything and mill it, because if you try to do that, what's going to happen is you're going to collapse it. Unless you have a wooden block to stick inside it and keep it from moving around. Alright, I'm going to take and use my slitting saw to go across the top and the bottom and mark where I want the notch to be. Get my glasses on so I can see what I'm doing. Alright, at this point I'm going to take a square cut jeweler's file, a square jeweler's file, not square cut, and begin working on this notch. Okay, when you think it's deep enough, you're free to go ahead and try it, check the fit, which is what we're going to do now. Pull our paper towel out of here. that's kept the dirt and the metal filings from getting inside of our magazine. Okay, now that the notch is complete, let's take this tape off of here and I'll show you how deep we went. Now, as you can see, we didn't go very deep at all. What I am going to do later is add a small bar of metal across the front of the magazine. I'll hit it on each side, TIG weld it in place to make it more sturdy. But it's actually not necessary, because if you hook it in just like you would if it was a standard AK mag, it locks in just fine in the front. Now, the back still needs some work. We still have to do a little bit of work to the back, and you got to be careful with that, because you know, if you don't fit a magazine properly, normally you're fitting the mag release to the magazine. What we're doing now is just going to be the opposite way around. I don't know how well you're going to see this. I'm going to try to focus in on it. Okay, hopefully you can see that okay. Shining the magazine, the flashlight in here at it, you can see just barely, I think you can probably see where the mag release is touching the bottom of the mag. I have to remove probably to start a 1/16 of an inch of metal off the bottom of our magazine. I'm going to reach in here and scribe a line on that, and I'm going to grind it or sand it off in the shape of a wedge, just like a standard AK magazine has the wedge shaped tab on the back. Okay, looking at the mark I put on the side of it, I'm going to scribe a line across the bottom of our locking tab here. Now obviously I think after you make this mod it will be useless for M14s. So keep that in mind if you have an M14 and you're going to want to use these magazines on it later on. Alright, now I'm going to sand a wedge onto our locking tab. And actually I need more light so that you can see it. Okay, I've got some tape on our magazine here. Now I'm going to sand on it. My sanding disc. Okay, I've got a wedge up to the line that I scribed on it. Now I'm going to check the fit in the gun and see how it fits. All right. Now with the original magazine, we had just 10 rounds. And that's all you get, 10 rounds. Now with this magazine we modified, and literally I've been out here probably 5 minutes, maybe 10. You got 20 rounds, locks in solid, with one bonus feature with these M14 mags that we did not have before. We have a bolt hold open. So that's a huge plus with the Checkmate Industry M14 mags, is now when you're shooting your M77, you have an automatic bolt hold open built into the magazine, which is pretty cool. Alright, that's it for this mod, guys. Didn't take long. I highly recommend it. Get yourself a couple of these Checkmate Industries mags. Variety of vendors have them. If you can find the ones from Taiwan that aren't fakes, now those also sell for about the same amount as the Checkmate Industry mags now. Use those. Don't be afraid to use one of the Taiwanese mags. They're made on US machinery. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. The next modification we're going to do on our Yugo M77 here is we're going to put the full US, or We're going to put enough U.S. parts in it to put the full military stock back on it. We're going to use the standard stock. I'm going to fix the slant cut and a receiver here. And we're going to put a U.S. made pistol grip, muzzle brake, and our U.S. fire control group. And of course, now we have our Checkmate Industry mags. We comply with 922R. So we're going to put the original wood furniture back on this. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to click like and subscribe, and I'll see you later.